So first you can tell me what happened. Well, tell me about the first day that you came across and what was going on here.
Well, we're getting, you know, close to spring, so I gathered some produce together, and I was heading out here to feed the prairie dogs, because I know spring is when they start having, that's their baby, and they start having babies in spring, and I came out here on Wednesday of last week, Wednesday evening, and I had noticed that they were beginning to do some kind of dirt moving work out here, and so I started to get concerned. And then I came back out on Thursday, and that's when I shot the video, and I saw the city workers back out with the earth movers, and they were doing more substantial work out here.
So right now, I saw one of your Facebook posts. You said that with the machines they were using, they were pretty much like covering up their dens, which they were not able to come out. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, anybody who knows the enclosure out here that's been out here to feed them before knows we had several dozen prairie dogs that lived in that enclosure in many den entrances. And their efforts were quite deliberate in making sure that they rolled over every single den entrance that was out here. And they came out and did it at a time when the ground was very soft because of the rain. So that helped them to compact the dirt down and to block all the den entrances. It made it easier for them to do that when normally when you want to do any kind of earth moving, you know, construction work, you don't really want to do it when the ground is wet. But it sure does make good for collapsing their den entrances and then plugging them up.
So I did talk to city officials this morning. What they were saying is, you know, it kind of won't affect them if they cover the holes, only because they're going to come right back up. What do you think about that?
No, I disagree. I think their activities is inherently dangerous to the animals and inhumane. Any time you roll construction machinery over the top of their burrows. And as you can see here, we're 4 days after the work that they did. And only a few of these prairie dogs have managed to extricate themselves back up from underground. And I contend that it was the city's plan all along to cull a high number of these animals, and that's the way they're doing it. They just avoided telling the truth about it.
Okay. So do you think by how they are working in this area, it's kind of putting them in danger, prairie dogs?
Well, it is. Inherently, it's going to be a dangerous activity when you work on the enclosure. It's going to put animals in jeopardy, and I don't disagree with the need for there to be improvements for this new to do some work here. That's not where my disagreement with them lies. It's in the methodology. It's in the fact that they told the people that they were going to trap these animals and relocate them and deal with them humanely first, and that's not what happened. And construction activity, if they had tried that, if they had gotten in touch with animal advocates in this town, such as myself or some of the other wildlife advocates or just volunteers, we could have gotten a lot of people together out here to try to humanely deal with this and give them a hand on that. But they didn't contact anybody. But I would have understood, at least if they had undertaken some initial steps to act humanely first, then I understand that when you go forward with any kind of work, you're going to miss some of the animals. In this case, what they've done here is that their acts are intentional, and that's where my problem is with them.
What do you mean by their intentional?
Well, because of the manner in which they went over it with the machinery, it was intended to cover up all the burrows, and they wouldn't have acted so deliberately if their intent wasn't to kill off a large number of these animals. And if they had survived all that, they would be digging themselves back up now. But like I said, we're 4 days after the fact, and you've only got a few of the prairie dogs that have been able to dig themselves back up from underground. On one hand, some city officials and the people who support that say, well, it's not going to hurt the prairie dogs at all. None of them were killed. They're not affected at all. And on the other hand, they're telling people that, well, their plan moving forward with this enclosure is to have maybe 50 prairie dogs, but by their estimate, there's 1,000 out here, so do the math. And now they're admitting that the plan is to euthanize some, when that wasn't the story they were giving people last week. That's certainly not what Mr. Points told me in a phone conversation with him.
So tell me a little bit more about that. Now, the press release from the city was just released this morning, and it did say that there might be too many prairie dogs that they're not going to be able to stay in their new home. So they might have to euthanize what do you think about that?
I understand there's concerns about population out here, and I've been contacted by prairie dog advocates in Colorado and other states who could possibly have placements for these animals. I don't think the city, to be honest, has really tried to pursue those avenues very seriously. I understand they may have asked Lubbock or a few other cities closer by and were declined. We're told that they didn't have room for them. I understand that. But that doesn't mean that we can't pursue other avenues like maybe Arrowhead or other prairie dog sanctuaries elsewhere, and maybe relocate some of these animals to start another colony somewhere else. There's all sorts of things that we could ask the question, try this yet, before resorting to the euthanasia. It's just my position is that I expected them to do this, and I believe culling was their intent from the start.
Okay. And then lastly, when it comes to what did you guys do right now? Did you gather a group of people right now?
I had a few supporters who met me out here, and we just came out and distributed some organic produce that was donated. Just went around to mainly the prairie dogs inside the enclosure here that needed the most, because they've got no foliage to eat around here. So we came out and distributed some food to them. Just kind of trying to make ourselves visible out here to show that there are people that are watching and who care about how you're conducting this work. I had maybe 6 or 7 out here that showed up. There were many others that want to come and that will be coming out on a rotating basis with me to help keep coverage out here. So there are many more that I'll be out with later. But today, when I was out here about 3:30, I had maybe 6 or 7.
Anything else you wanted to say for city officials or for community members who are watching?
Not that you could.
All right, then. Well, thank you very much.